5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Hello, hello, and welcome. Welcome back to Space Engineers on the Xbox, on the Series X, and on April the 15th, 2 years ago, Space Engineers released on the Xbox, and my first ever video went up on April the 27th, I believe, or the 25th. I can't quite remember without looking, but it's almost the channel's 2 year anniversary. But it is past the game's 2 year anniversary on the Xbox, and I started with a grouping tutorial. And I've seen questions on the XSEC, the Xbox Space Engineers community on Facebook, talking still about how to group things and how to select things. And this hopefully serves as the de facto Xbox grouping tutorial for Space Engineers for my channel from this point going forward, because I've looked at my first video. That's way out of date because Keen brought in a brand new method for updating, for creating groups and so on, that's a lot easier. And I've gone through some of my other videos, and I've not got a specific video that just says, bam, this is the brand new method. This is all the button combinations. These are all the button combinations you can use to group something. So we're going to just take my test antenna for boom here, and we're going to slap our whole host of thrusters on there. And we're going to build, let's see, first things first. We're going to build in plane mode. Now, if you want to know how to change the mode of building in Creative, just put a block up, then click in the right stick, go to the build menu, and just tap through single block, line, plane. Release the left stick and press in the right bumper. Now, it will take off the block you had currently selected, so bring that back up. And now you can build in plane mode, which saves you putting down a whole host of blocks like this individually in Creative. So now we've got that, we're going to take a look at the control panel. Now, this is my control panel over here. We can use this, or, but I'm going to slap down the control seat in a second. But this is a station. And if you want to know how to change your ship to a station and vice versa, go into your control panel, go to the info tab and press X, convert to ship, or press X, convert to station. Now, it won't convert to a station or so on if any part of the voxels are intersecting with any part of your grid. So if a landing gear is slightly stuck in the ground, it won't work. That said, let's snap open our build menu with the left stick, grab our control seat, pop it down, and jump into the control seat. Hold down both bumpers and tap the inventory button, the two squares, and you're in the control panel. Now, to make things easier, we want just the ions. So go to search and use ion as your search value. And we'll select all the ions. There's your first ion at the top. So if we want to select the first ion and the last ion, we can do that. But first of all, let's look at methods for selection. One, holding down the right bumper and pressing A. We'll select the block that you're highlighting. I'm using the D-pad to move up and down the list. And if I want to go across to any other window, I'm using the left stick. So if I want only four of these thrusters, if I keep the right bumper held down and press A on each individual thruster, I can select them as I want. I can do each individual thruster, or as long as I keep my right bumper held down, I can just keep selecting things as and when, and deselecting them. If I let go of the right bumper and I press A on any of these thrusters, it will select that one. So that's your first method. Your next method is holding down the right bumper on a block that's not selected. Pressing A. If it deselects like that, keep the right bumper held down. Press A again and hold A down. Do not release A. Now hold down on the D-pad and you'll keep selecting thrusters. All well and good, but there is an easier way to select your entire list of thrusters. Hold down the left bumper and press A. Then move the D-pad down and press A again. You'll see that we are now selecting between the first thruster and the thruster where we pressed A. If you keep that left bumper held down, hold down on the D-pad until you get near the bottom of the list, and then tap it until you're right at the bottom, thruster 99, and then press A again, you'll select every thruster on that list. Now, with every thruster on that list selected like that, you can now go across to your block group with the left stick. Just press A on block group. Name it something like Ion. I always use the ship name. So if the ship was called the Zombie, I would call it, say, Zom Ion or something like that. And save. Now we have a block group which we can use. If we hold A direction on the D-pad, we will open the toolbar config menu on the controller. So let's say we wanted this on up. So we hold down that. It brings up the toolbar config. We then tap down with the right bumper till we get to groups. We choose Zomion and choose toggle block on off. Let's go into first person view. Third person view. By holding down the right bumper, tapping up on the D-pad, and then we can alter the camera angle by holding both bumpers down and moving the right stick. If we want to zoom in and out, we keep both bumpers held down, move the left stick. You can see all my glorious iron engines. And if I hit on off, they'll turn off, on, off, on. And there you go. That is that. Let's go back to first person. Jump back into the control panel. Let's say I wanted to give this entire grid to someone, to the space pirates. If I was making one of the PVE drone spawners that I've got a video on, you could do that to give the ship to the space pirates. And the best way to do it is hold down both bumpers and double tap A. You'll select every block on that grid, including the blocks that are off screen. Selects the whole grid. That will also select the block group. So you could, if you want, deselect that block group by holding the right bumper and pressing A, because that's something else you can do once you've got a block group you don't want. Say you don't want the battery given to the space pirates. Hold down right bumper, press A. Do not press A on its own, because you'll just select the block underneath. But you can just add and remove blocks as you want to the grid. And that's it. That's really all you need to know about how to select blocks. on a grid. So the left bumper is if you want to use the band select method where you go from one component to the next. So iron thruster backward to iron thruster 18 backward. If I want to remove iron thruster 13 backward from the list, I hold down right bumper and tap A. Same for iron thruster 11. If I want to put them back in the list, I hold down right bumper and tap A on the blocks that I want to put back in the list. And that's all there is to it. Hopefully that's demystified this particular element of Space Engineers for you, giving you a straightforward to the point tutorial on it that you could come back to and just focus on that particular part of the tutorial. That is all I really want to do with this video. I did say that one of my other videos is going to be on the share inertia tensor function. Again, it's going to be a similar kind of thing to this. So there you go. Enjoy your Easter, and I will see you in the next one. Take care, stay safe, happy engineering. Lots more to come, and I have a feeling lots more to come from Keen Software House as well. Space Engineers is going to change, as I keep on saying. Until then, though, we will keep on keeping on. Bye for now.